असुरान अभिभूय स्वं देव भाव शास्त्र प्रकाशित प्रतिपद्याम इत्युक्तवंत अन्योन्यम। इट इज सेड टू ईच अदर वी शल रियलाइज अवर ओन डिविनिटी एज स्टेटेड और पुट फॉर्थ इन द स्क्रिप्चर्स बाय सरपासिंग द डेमन्स। असुरान अभिभूय आफ्टर सरपासिंग द डेमन्स स्वं देव भावम अवर ओन डिवाइन फॉर्म शास्त्र प्रकाशितम एज पुट फोर्थ और सेट फोर्थ स्टेटेड इन द स्क्रिप्चर्स प्रतिपद्यामहे वी शल अटेन और वी शल रियलाइज दिस इज व्हाट द डेट इज इत्युक्तवंतो अन्योन्यम दे सेड टू ईच अदर। उद्गीत कर पदार्थ कर्तृ स्वरूप लक्षण उद्गीत कर पदार्थ कर्तृ स्वरूप लक्षण च ज्ञान कर्मभ्याम। But how they are going to attain that Udgita Karma, the Kartas Swarupam, the Chanter's Swarupam, how they are going to be the identity with the Chanter of the Udgita? That's why the identity with the Chanter of Udgita is attained by Jnana Karma Bhyan, through meditation and the right, that particular action of singing by the Udgata. Udgita Karma, the singing of the special part of a sama called Udgita is done by a person called Udgata, and identity with him is called as Udgita Kara Padartha Kartri Swarupa Ashrayanam. That they will be attaining, the deities will be attaining by Jnana and Karma, by the meditation and the rite they are performed on. Karma, what is that karma? And what is the Jnana through which these deities are going to attain identity? That's why stated karma is vakshyamanam mantra japa lakshanam vidhityamanam tadetani japediti. The rites consist of repetition of mantras that will be vakshyamanam, will be presently, vidhityamanam will be enjoined by the words tadetani japet. These mantras are to be repeated in the last mantra of this section 1328. The mantras are asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityo ma amritam gamaya, tadetani japyaditi. And what is the jnanam? Meditation. Idam eva nirupyamanam, this only that which is being stated over here, the story, this whole story what is being stated, and especially on the vital force with all the attributes of different organs. This is the meditation. Nirupyamanam, that which is being stated. Jnanam idameva nirupyamanam. And by here, one thing what I want to mention, yagya, by the word yagya, you cannot take any general sacrifice. Is it not? Why? Because Bhaskar says Jyotishthoma. But on what basis Bhaskar is telling this Jyotishthoma? The basis is on these mantras which has to be repeated. And these mantras, repetition is called as Abhyaroha Japa in Karmakanda. The name of it is called as Abhyaroha. In the next page, second line, it is written Abhimukhyena Arohati Deva Bhav Manenaiti Abhyaroha. It is a Bhashyam. Nanu idam Abhyaroha Japa Vidhi Shesho Arthavado Nanna Jnana Nirupana Param Bhashyam. On that the Anandagiri says, what is the Abhyaroha Japa means? Abhimukhyan Arohati Deva Bhava Maniniti Abhyaroha. By which these deities are going to attain that particular form, or the person, the Yajamana, the agent is going to attain the Deva Bhava, the identity with the deity, by doing the repetition of these mantras. Abhimukhyan Arohati Deva Bhava Anena. Anena means through this mantra japa. That mantra japa is called as Abhyaroha Mantra Japa. That is being enjoined in the 28th mantra of the section. So, this whole story should be just an eulogy for that enjoining, the injunction of the japa. Because any vidhi, the stories usually are stuti of that vidheya. Therefore, any injunction is there, usually that thing which is being enjoined is being praised by some story. Therefore, this whole story should be only a praise, an eulogy. Why you are saying this is a meditation itself? You said from now onwards you are going to state the meditation and the karma is in the last one. But the Purupaksha, the objector says, no, no, it cannot be so. This is a part of injunction. That japa, the mantra japa, abhyaro japa, is a part of an injunction. That is the repetition of the mantras, leading to attainment of divinity. Therefore, this story is just an arthavada of that vidhi. Abhyaro japa vidhi, shesho arthavado. Because in Mimamsa darshan you have to go a little bit now to understand this vidhi shesha. Because any vidhi, according to as you have heard in Artha Sangra, any vidhi has got Shabdi Bhavana and Arti Bhavana. In Shabdi Bhavana, you are taking the Bhavyakamsa, Sadhya, Sadhana and Iti Kartavyata. In this what you have said is that Sadhyansha is by which? Anshatrope Arti Bhavana. Ansha Traya. Yukta Arti Bhavana is Sadhyam of Shabdi Bhavana. Okay? And Sadhanansha is the link Pratyaya from which you are going Shabdi Bhavana. And Iti Kartata is, as we studied, Prashastim, all Arthavada. That is why I am telling now. The Iti Kartavata, the Vidhi Shesha, Vidhi, any Majja Vidhi has got Shabdi Bhavana. In that Shabdi Bhavana, the Shesha, the Anshas, Shesha means Ansha, part, is Sadhya, Sadhana Iti Kartata, Kim Kena Katham. And in this Katham part, the Shesha is the Arthavada. Therefore it says Vidhi Shesha Arthavada. Abhyaro Japa Vidhi, Jape, in that Jape is the link, Jape, Ta, Prate. And for that the Itikarta is added as Itikarta Arthava is added over there. Therefore, this whole story of this Prana Sanghata, Devasura Sangrama, story that is going on, it should be an Arthavada as a part of the injunction of Japa, a part of it. Idam abhyaro japa vidhi shesho arthavado na jnana nirupana param. Therefore, this story cannot be meant for describing the meditation. This is not at all mentioning the meditation, but this whole story means just an eulogy, a part as eulogy of the injunction regarding this abhyaroha japa. Because this abhyaroha japa is a part of Jyotishtome Yaga. That's what Bhashyakara said. Yagya means Jyotishtome. And in Jyotishtoma, actually not only Jyotishtoma, any Yaga in which Som Yaga is done, is performed. Because this mantra japa is a part of Som Yaga. And Som Yaga is a part of Jyotishtoma, Ashwamedha and Rajasuya. Therefore, any yaga which is consisting of Soma Yaga as a part, they will have to do Sabhyaro Japa. Therefore, this whole thing is Karmakanda. Where your Vedanta and why it is brought to Brihadaranyaka-upanishadanda? Unnecessarily. This is the object of saying so. Because that's why he wants to take this whole story as an eulogy. The system is there in Jyotishtoma. When a Soma Yaga is being performed in the middle of Jyotishtoma, any Somya consists of three Pavamanas. 12 Stotras are there. Out of the three are called Pavamana. Again, the whole chart also after saying that you can see the Pratakka in Bhush Pavamana, Madhinka in Madhin Pavamana, and said Ardho Pavamana in the evening. And whenever this Pavamana Stotra is being sung, out of the 12 Stotras, the Pavamana Stotra when is being sung, before that, Trayanam part of the pra. Yajamanena kriyamano japaha is abhyaro japa. The performer, the agent, not the priests. Yajamana, the person has to do this japa. Asdoma, sadgamaya, etc. That's abhyaro japa. Therefore, this is meant for a karma gandhi. This japa itself, totally. Whether it is upasa samuchita karma gandha or only karma, but this has to be done by Yajamana. By the agent of the karma. There is no relation with meditation or any Upanishadic text. Therefore, this has to be related totally with the karma only, this whole portion which you are studying here. This is what the objectors want to say. But Siddhanta says, no, no. Why? The reason is, yayevam veda iti vachana. Because here it is stated, yayevam veda. 137. Yeah, tippan is that 137? One number tippan? 137. Yayevam veda iti vachana. Since the text narrates, that is clearly states over here, it cannot be an eulogy and not be meant for injunction of some meditation, that you can't say, for it has been stated very clearly in the seventh mantra of this section. He who knows thus, he is going to attain such and such a result. That means this is meditation. If this would have been a totally story, merely a story, then how the mantra can say, yeah, eva veda, he is going to attain such a result, how this can be stated? As and because the seventh mantra is telling very clearly, he who knows this is going to attain such and such a result. Therefore, it is very clear, this is a meditation, not only a story. Udgita prastave prakalpa shravanad udgita vidiparam iti chet na. But again the object says, since the text narrates an old story, prakalpa means an old story is called as prakalpa. An old story is being shravanad, narrated and heard by us, where? Udgita prastave, in context of Udgita. Thus, Udgita vidhi para, therefore this part should be a part of injunction of Udgita only. No, a prakarana. Siddhanti says the prakarana is not of Udgita at all. Nowhere before, nowhere later we are discussing anything about Udgita. A prakarana, that is not the context. Udgita sucha anitra vihitatva. Because the Udgita has been enjoined elsewhere in the Karmakanda part, not in this Upanishad. Not the Upanishad section of the Veda. Udgita has been enjoined, but not here. There is no Udgita vidhi anywhere in this third section. Udgita vidhi is elsewhere. Therefore, this story cannot be joined to that. You can't enjoin over right there. Why? Because Vidyapakaranatva chasya. Because this whole, with the previous you have studied all the two Brahmins, two sections. In those two sections, only meditation was there. There is nothing related with karma. A person who has no right to do a right, he is entitled to do the meditation of Ashwamedha meditation. There is totally, it is meant only for those people who are not fit for or eligible for doing any rites. Therefore this, the one which is in between, thus first and second you have seen so. Again, fourth you will be seeing same. The one that is in between a Sandanshan Nyaya comes again. According to that, even this should be not related with any of the Karmakanda. Therefore, this Prakarana, according to the before and that is the later one, you have to see. In the middle of this is also a Vidya Karanadi, which is related to a context of meditation only over here. Abhyaro Japasya Nityatva. Not only that, the repetition of the mantra, which is meant over here to attain identity with the gods, with the deities, etc., as you stated. By the name itself, Abhyaro means to, that is meant to attain identity with the deity. This is not at all independent. Anityam is here. Don't take it as Vinashi or like that. Anityam is not independent. It is dependent on meditation. A person is going to do meditation on vital force, has to do this japa. If you are not going to do meditation vital force, you need not do the japa. Evam vit prayojyatva. Why it is not independent? It says, evam vit prayojyatva. Because it is to be practiced by one who does this meditation on the vital force as described. Vijnanasya cha nityavachrutatva. And meditation of the vital force as described in this section is being heard of to be totally independent. Vijnanasya nityavah means, nityavat means just like independent. It is being heard of to be as independent. Nityavat shrutatva. Vijnanasya. The meditation that has been enjoined over here is heard of to be as totally independent. Therefore, without japa also you can do meditation. But without meditation you can't do japa. Because japa abhyaro japa is a part of meditation. Thus it is not a part of any karmakanda at all. And meditation is not a part of anything else. You are free to do with karma or without karma also. Vigyaja nitya shodhatshrutatvat taddhaidat lokajidhivitya shrudehe. For a separate result is mentioned for the meditation. Iticha shruti is a separate result is mentioned for the meditation other than the japa result. The result of japa is to attain the form of the deities. And the result of the meditation is what? To attain the rewards. This lokajit eva, this certainly wins the performer of the meditation, these words. This is what is in the same 28th mantra, the last mantra, the result of meditation has been stated along before the japa. No, not Chandogya. 1328. Tad dhaitat lokajit eva iti cha shrudehe. No. Same number they have Chandogya they have printed. No. This is Brahmanya. Because how you can say, because we are space, want to show the object, the result of meditation, the result of karma, abhyaro japa karma is different. Therefore, meditation has been enjoined here with result. Thus, this whole story should be a meditation and not a part of any karma kanda. For that, we are giving this mantra. Therefore, the meditation has been studied yayavam veda. The meditation has been enjoined here and the result is mentioned in Chandogya. How is it possible? You have to correct it. Brui. No, cha. You are right. Bri. Pranasya vagadina cha shuddhi ashuddhi vachana. Another reason. One reason was given as aprakarna. Yayam veda iti vachana. Because there is injunction of meditation. First reason. Second reason is aprakarna. This is not the contest of Udgita at all. Third reason was the meditation is nitya, independent. Whereas japa is anitya, not independent. The fourth reason was the result has been given separate for meditation. The fifth reason is now been given as pranasya vagalanja shuddhya shuddhi vachana. Pranasya, moreover, the vital force has been stated to be pure. And vagadinancha, the organs to be impure. Why is this? He is going to explain his own statement now. Nai anupasitte pranasya shuddhi vachanam vagadinancha saupanyasthanam ashuddhi vachanam. If by this we are going to imply this thing, but this implies that the vital force is enjoined as an object of meditation. If it would not have been so, anupasitte, then if it would not have been so, then it would not be logical also. Nai upapadyate is that. Two statements are there, the whole statement. Nahi anupasite pranashuddhi vachanam vagadinancha saupanyasthanam ashuddhi vachanam. And vagadi nindaya mukhi pranashuddhischa abhipreta nahi upapadyate. That means it would not be logical if the pranasya anupasite, prana would not be an object of meditation, then to praise it, you are telling it is pure, shuddhi vachanam. To state it to be pure and vagadinancha saupanyasthanam. And although these speech etc. organs that are being mentioned along with this vital force are stated to be impure, ashuddhi vachanam, this is not logical to say so. Number one. The other thing is vagadi nindaya. By saying them as to be impure, indirectly, what you are doing? You are actually praising the vital force. Therefore, vagadi nindaya mukhya pranasudhischa. Vagadi nindaya mukhya pranastischa abhipreta na upapadyate. Na bochube na vachanam na upapadyate. And abhipreta sudhischa na upapadyate. Not only that, further is saying mrityum atikranto dipyate ityadi falavachanancha. Mrityum atikranto dipyate ityadi falanancha. And also this statement regarding the result, enunciation of the result of the meditation on it having transcending the death itself, he shines very well. This I am stating in the 12th mantra 1312. Mrityum atikranto dipyata. Ippana we will look at 1312, fine number.
Huh?
Nahi upapadyate.
But this is
there's a put one comma there, there's a Shuddhi Vachana, after that you put one comma. There's not different sentence. Nahi Upapade one sentence, in that two portions been stated for his own explanation. Because before he said Pranasya Vagadhinamcha Shuddhi, Shuddhi Vachana is one the reason given. That's been explained now. There's in two parts has been explained. This Vachanam is not logical, number one, and the other thing, the praises are not logical.
But praise usually done.
Huh?
Praise is usually done.
That's why it is not logical if prana is not anupasyatve, he said. If prana is anupasya, then it's not logical. If it's upasya, then it's logical. Because the beginning is see, anupasyatve pranasya. Shuddhi vachanam, vagadinancha, shuddhi vachanam, na upapadyate. And same thing now, anupasitta pranasya, vagadinandiya, mukhya prasutir, avipreta na upapadyate. That's how you have to take it. Murtyumati kranto dipyate ityadi valavachananja. And also the annunciation of the result of stating about regarding this meditation on that particular prana. Every prana also I said, Murtyumati kranto. Murtyu, every time it is from 12 to 17. Every time this result has been stated. That also he says, being transcending the death and he shines very well. This also cannot be logical. If there was no meditation in this part. Prana surupa patteri phalam tad yad vagadi nam agniyadi bhavaha. And finally, the identification of the organs, speech etc. with prana. Prana surupapatte of whom vagadina, the identification of the organs of speech etc. with the vital force etc. Vital force prana surupapatte hi agniyadi bhava, and that too how with fire etc. is the result of attaining oneness with the vital force. The vak actually, this identification of the organs of speech etc. is taking place with fire etc. Because who is the deity of vak? Fire. Who is the deity of chakshu? Sun. Therefore these organs attain identity with their own deities. On what basis? By getting identified with the vital force. That way he says, vagadinam agnyadi bhavaha yat phalam tad hi pranasurpapattehe. The organs, speech etc. they attaining the identity with their own deities, fire etc., which is the result that they are attaining is due to the apatte, surupapatte with prana, with the identification of the vital force. And the Purapakshi says, Bhavatu nama prana pranasyupasanam natu tut vishuddhyadi gunavattayati. This is the use of vishuddhi. Ayatanattam, Pratishtattam, other guna is there. Many gunas, every indriya says, whatever guna I have, that is yours only. All the indriyas, all the organs will give their own attributes to the vital force. And that is how you have to meditation. The prana is, the vital force is pure. The vital force is ayatana. It is pratishta. It is this, it is that. That is how you have to meditate. The Purpakshi says, I don't accept that. Okay, I accept there is meditation on vital force. But I don't accept these. The Shuddhattam, Ayatrattam, etc. as the attributes of vital force. Bhavatu nava pranasya upasana. Okay, let it be so that here meditation on vital force is being enjoined. Nato vishuddhyadi gunavatta. But it cannot be possessed of the attributes of like purity, etc. Iti. Siddhanti says, nanu syat. Shrutatva. Here nanu is an eva. There's a tippan, is there nanu? Eight number tippan. Nanu avadharane. Shrutatva gunavatta pisyad eva ityartha. Shrutatva eva. It is an eva. Shrutatva syad eva. It must be. It must be. Why? For shrutatva the upanishad says so. That you have to accept them as the attributes of the vital force. And meditate upon the vital force with these attributes only. Again the object is no. Na syat upasati sutyartatva pratyaye. Because no, for the vital force being an object of meditation, it is logical to say that these attributes are mentioned as only eulogy for praise of that vital force. Actually, the vital force does not have any quality, no attribute. It is only to praise it to be stated that this vital force has got Shuddhatam and all its attributes. How?
Because there
are
no gunas for the
Mukha Prana. Why not? All gunas are due to Mukha Prana only.
No, but actually for Mukha Prana there are no gunas, no qualities, no attributes.
If it had no qualities, how can the qualities come to in others? There are qualities in it due to which it gives, distributes its own qualities to different organs little. It is itself distributing. That's why the prana itself establishes in different forms in this body as organs. That's why all the organs are called as prana. All the organs are totally called as prana. That is prana, the mukhya prana itself is establishing in this body in the form of different organs. Then whatever you are seeing, the attributes, the qualities in the organs are nothing but of that prana only. Your prana consists of all these qualities. If it did not have consisted of it, these qualities, then how it would have come into the organs, which is its own form. Therefore, you have to accept that all these are there. This is what one, but the Purva says no. The Purva seems to be right, but it's not like that. Shastra Bhashya says no, not so. Avipritartha pratipatte shreha prapti upatte lokavat. This is in the world, you have seen in naturally that avipritartha pratipatte shreha prapti upatte hai. Because the reason is proper understanding alone leads us to what we wish to attain. Is it not? There is a proper understanding of that. If you want to go to Badrinath, you should have proper understanding over the whole route. That will go to some other way. The taxi driver will take some other route, means what you are going to do? You don't know. Therefore, we should have a proper understanding of the whole route to attain the destination. Similarly, here, Shreya Prapti, the human goal, is called a Shreya. To attain that, a proper understanding of things should be there. And similarly, here also, you are going to attain a higher goal by the meditation of vital force. For that, you will have to understand the vital force properly with all its qualities. Without a proper understanding of the meditative thing with its qualities, you will not be able to meditate on it properly. Thereby, you will not be attained to the highest goal of the human life, that which you want to attain by meditation. This is common rule he is telling first. Lokavat, that's why he says Bhashyakara. As it is in this worldly matters. Local means loka vivhare yatha. As it is seen in the worldly matters, a proper understanding leads to the ends properly, leads to you the goal, to the goal properly. Similarly, in the scriptural matters like meditation, etc., also a proper understanding is very much needed. Avipritartha means proper understanding. Vipritartha pratipatti is wrong understanding. Avipritartha pratipatti is proper understanding, correct understanding. Shreya prapti upatte, by that only the goal can be attained properly. Lokvat, as in the external world. He explains his own statement further. Yohi avipritam vartam pratipatte loke, sa ishtam prapnoti, anishtadva nivartate. Any one thing can happen. In this world, it is seen that Yohi avipritam artham pratipadyate, that person who has a proper correct understanding, then what is going to attain? Ishtam prapnoti anishtadva nivartate. A person who understands the things correctly, properly, attains what he wishes. Or he avoids himself from what is evil. Anishtadva nivartate. Na vipritartha pratipatya, and not by a wrong understanding. Because if a person has a wrong understanding, he is not attaining what he wants to attain good. And he can't avoid himself from what is evil. Because he has a wrong understanding. Tathaya, further is going to explain later on this statement. If you understand a foe as a friend, Bhaskara said, Amitram Mitra Iva Idi. After that, he will explain this thing. Then, how you can attain good and how you can avoid yourself from evil? You as a foe, you are understanding him as a friend, an enemy as a friend. Will he ever do good to you? And surely we'll attain evil. We cannot avoid ourselves from that. And a wrong understanding is going to cause evil, guaranteed, no doubt. That's why Bhaskara says, Navipritartha Pratipatya. Tatha is as if Lokavat has been explained by this. Tatha yapi. Similarly, in the scriptural matters too. Shaut Shad Janitartha Pratipatta, Shriha Pratirupanna, Navipuryaye. Similarly, here also, one can attain the highest human goal, Shriha Pratirupanna. It's logical to say that a person can attain the human goal by only when one who what? Shraut Shad Janit Artha Pratipatta. When a person correctly understands the meaning of the Upanishadic words and Naviparaya and not otherwise. If we misunderstand or misinterpret any single mantra also, we will not be able to attain the import of the Upanishads. Nacha upasanartha shruta shabda shabdottha vijnana vishayasya ayathartatve pramanam asti. And you cannot say that this is ayathartam also. Apramanikam ayathartam. Besides nacha, there is ayathartatve pramanam nasti. You take like that first. Ayathartatve pramanam nasti. There is nothing to disprove the truth. Ayathartatam, truth. Ayathartatam, to disprove the truth. We don't have any pramanam, na pramanam asti. We don't have any method by which we can disprove what is being stated over here. That to what? Ayathartatva what? Vishayasya, of an object. What is the object here? Vijnana vishayasya, corresponding to certain notions. And that notion from her? Shruta Shabdottha. Upasanartha Shruta Shabdottha. Notions that have been conveyed by the words of the scriptures that are enjoining meditations on the particular, here at present, vital force. Upasana, artha upasana for the meditation purpose. Shruta Shabda, the words of the scriptures that are conveying us certain vijnana notions of which are the objects, vital force, etc. Regarding this, ayathartatve, to disprove this to be untruth, there is no pramana at all with us. There is no method of any conception or perception by which you can disprove this. Nachitun vijnana, vijnanasya apavada shruyate. And in the later portion of this Upanishad and especially in this section also, there is nothing has been stated by which you are going to have an exception and state that this is not a meditation. Unless and until there is an exceptional statement, apavada, an exceptional statement, you cannot reject this as a meditation. Vijnanasya apavada nacha shruyate. Tata shreha prapti darshanat yathartam pratipadyamahe. Since we see that meditation is conducive to our well-being, shreha prapti darshanat, we are seeing that this is going to give us our shreya, our good, our well-being. Therefore, yathartam pratipadyamahe, therefore we accept it as true as it is. Viparyecha, because and we see that on the contrary, anartha prapti darshanat, that it will lead us to evil. If we don't accept what the Upanishads are saying and we are not ready to follow it, then we are seeing that we are going to attain always evil only. Yohi viparyena artham prativate loke purusham sthanavirdi amitram mitram itiva so anartham prapnuvan drishyate. So it comes up now. Because a person if he understands anything wrongly, then there would be a very source of evil. What? It is seen in the world, he says, Yo hi viparinartham prithi loke. Loke means in this world, it is seen that any person who misperceives things like purusham sthanuridi, a man is understood as a stump, amitram mitramidi, a foe as a friend, then what is going to happen? Anartham prapnuvan drishyate. That person surely is going to attain evil, there is no doubt in it. This is what is being seen in this world. There are similarities in the scriptural matters too. If we are going to misinterpret and misunderstand any mantra also, then we'll be leading ourselves to evil, no doubt.